Hello, this is Trooper Harp, here to talk about GAR's newest update, the Halloween update. This was the first time I got to experience a Halloween event in GAR, so that's probably going to affect my opinion on it since I have nothing else to compare it to, but from what I've heard, this is a bit of a different update for GAR. For the most part in the past, GAR only really changed up the map every holiday and maybe introduced a few new game passes, but this time around, they decided to introduce a calendar system, some quests, and a boss fight, which on paper sounds really cool, getting free prizes for logging into the game every day, getting to accomplish an overarching quest that spans a few days, and getting to fight a boss at the end. But in execution, it was... there was more to be desired. It was pretty lackluster. Let's start with the calendar, since that's the easiest thing to get out of the way. To me, the rewards on the calendar were kind of not great. I understand GAR can't exactly give out free weapons to people, but I feel like they could have given us something else for free. You know, maybe some new pets that aren't just the Gonk Droid, or... maybe at least give us the Halloween blaster for longer than a day. Like, I would like to keep that permanently, since the only way to buy the Halloween blaster is to get a Halloween morph. There's no separate game paths for it or anything, so it would have been a nice reward for all the players who stuck around until the end, but oh well. All of the prizes you gain through the calendar are temporary, and it's not permanent. The only prize you can get throughout this entire event that you can keep forever is the Gonk Droid when you defeat the boss. Something that's not even technically on the calendar. Sure, technically, the quest is locked to the calendar, but I don't count that as a reward. That's more of just a lock. Let's talk about the quest next. Now that we got that out of the way, if we can even call it a quest, that is, the only gameplay in the quest is walking around Coruscant and talking to people, watching cutscenes happen, which is fine, but it really sucked when experiencing the event live. For those of you who are looking in from the future, this quest was divided up into days, so we would talk to Yoda one day, and then Yoda would tell us to go talk to Rex, and then Rex would be like, oh, we really need to come up with a plan. Come back tomorrow. And then when we'd come back tomorrow, and then Rex would tell us again to wait until tomorrow for the boss fight. And then the boss fight got delayed a few times, but oh well. That was kind of not their fault at all. There was just some bugs and stuff. But the story itself was just really lackluster and not worth, like, the daily wait. I mean, it was really cool to see the Jedi Council, even though I'm pretty sure Aayla Secura is not on the Jedi Council, despite her being there. And I also found it kind of boring that they're just in one of the apartment buildings and not, like, at the Jedi Council or something. Like, I couldn't make a new location for them to sit in to talk, which, why? It just makes me think that the three of the Jedi Council was just sitting in their apartment building, got a call from Rex, and they were like, oh shit, well, we can't really make it to the Jedi Council, so I guess we'll just fucking have our meeting here, why not? Aside from that, that's really all the gameplay there is, just walking around Coruscant talking to people. There could have been more, like maybe a mini-boss, like with a droid that had information about the villain's plan or whatever, but I guess that was too much. I do have to understand that these updates are made, like, in a very short amount of time, and they don't really have the time to make, like, unique boss fights. The fact that we got one is pretty impressive, but, you know, I would have liked a little more, and I'm hoping for future events this Halloween, like, event gets better over the years, and they don't just recycle it the same way every year. Like, maybe add some new locations, new things to do during the event, and maybe take inspiration from this event and apply it to other events like the Christmas one or the Easter one or whatever GAR decides to celebrate for whatever reason. Okay, before I get ahead of myself, let's talk about the boss fight, which was pretty good, by the way. It kind of made it worth the wait. It's a nice, enjoyable time, like, especially with a group of people. I never knew how well a boss would translate into, like, GAR's gameplay, but it's really fun to, like, squad up with people and, like, prepare a strategy to fight him. Even though the boss isn't, like, perfectly programmed, I'll get into that in a second, but if you want some advice from me, go to one of the weapons dealers and buy a healing gun for a day, because you're definitely gonna need it. Because, oh boy, does this boss do a lot of damage, and it's really hard to dodge his attacks. His hitboxes, to me, feel a bit unfair, because, like, I swear I will run for my life trying to get away from him, but he'll still hit me even though his hammer is far away. I think it's the shockwaves on the ground that are damaging me, but to me, like, it's really hard to not get hurt at all on that boss fight. A healing gun is essentially mandatory. But other than that, like, I think it's a pretty fun fight. By the way, to any 501st members watching this, our perk is absolutely broken on this boss. I won't elaborate further, because I'm sure that the 501st can understand why. I also really liked the new location that the boss was set in. Even though it was a little bit small, just a little hallway with a boss battle room, it was pretty okay. I really liked the vibe of it. Like, it was like a really dark, spooky, like, ruins? Mansion? Something? I don't know. It just had a great atmosphere for me, personally. And it kind of makes me hope that in the future, when GAR does these events, like, they'll go all out and they'll do stuff like this. Like, have, like, a separate room to fight a boss or do something, like, play a minigame or something. Like, just a new, unique location. It also makes me hope that someday GAR will finally update their map, because in my opinion, it hasn't really changed all that much since 2020, at least the basic layout. I know that, like, they've added a few new things, like the armory, the FOB area, and they also updated a lot of the textures, but overall, the gameplay loop of GAR is very boring, because there's not a lot to do in it. You can defend the bank and the armory and attend patrols, and that's really about it. And I guess invasions, and you know the deal. It gets boring very fast, and it's kind of hard to stick with it. If I didn't join a division, I probably still wouldn't be here. But anyway, I really like this update. I think that they're heading in the right direction. I really hope that Viking Law focuses on this game a little more, maybe add some of the stuff from his other game he's working on, maybe add a job system, finally use up some of those buildings that have nothing in them or just exist to exist, like the clothing shop. Like, why is it there? It doesn't do anything. Whatever. Anyway, before I go on a ramble for too long, I hope you all enjoyed this video. I'm a bit new to this thing. I don't know. bye-bye.